Welcome back to the Michigan Business Beat, brought to you on the Michigan Business Network. Chris Holman here on the island for the policy conference put on by the Detroit Regional Chamber of Commerce. And who would you expect to be here but the head of MEDC, Jeff Mason. Jeff, it's good to see you. How you doing, bud?
I'm doing great, Chris.
Excellent.
You guys are kind of stealing the show up here. You made a major announcement. Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Well, I mean, last week we had a kind of a groundbreaking generational announcement in terms of Fiat Chrysler announcing that they're going to open a new assembly plant in downtown Detroit. $4.5 billion of investment and employing about 6,500 people in the Southeast Michigan region. So it was a good week last week.
So this always crops into my head because the number one problem business is having is getting talent. Are these expected to be new employees? And I'm wondering where we're getting them.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that certainly was one of the issues that was discussed between the state, the city of Detroit, and the company. Actually, I was talking to someone yesterday that said that 12,000 people have already gone online and expressed some interest about those 6,000 jobs.
That should fill them.
So, you know, I think there's a lot of people that are looking at, you know, career opportunities to move up, people that are coming back into the workforce. So we'll figure that out. That's a good problem to have.
Well, and Stephanie Buckhorn, to give her a little shout out, she's doing a great job over at TED for you, too.
They are. I mean, we work closely with Stephanie and her team. Part of the whole package was to provide some state resources to help with workforce and with training, working with Jeff Donofrio down at the City of Detroit and their workforce team to really kind of bring, you know, the right kind of package together to help the company when they're going to go in production sometime in 2020. So they're on a pretty fast pace to build the plant and start producing vehicles.
Awesome stuff. Well, you had an announcement up here, too, on the island.
We did. We announced with Pure Michigan Business Connect with Consumers Energy and DTE. Consumers and DTE are going to make a $15 billion commitment over the next 5 years, spending about $1.5 billion a year per company in terms of buying locally with Michigan suppliers. So all that does is help to, you know, stimulate and turn those dollars over within the state of Michigan.
You know, I remember when this first started and Consumers and DTE said, we're going to do $1 million. And they blew by that in about 10 days, I think.
You know, it's not about, you know, buying and paying more for the products or buying inferior products. It's, look at, when things are all equal in terms of the quality and the cost, why not buy from our neighbors? And DTE and Consumers have really stepped up and made that commitment to do so. So we applaud them for that.
Well, you guys, MEDC has done such an incredible job at spawning things and finding, I guess, an identity as a matchmaker. I mean, you do such a great job of putting potential employees in front of employers, of putting suppliers in front of, you know, purchasers, that kind of a thing. Is that the path you're going to pretty much continue?
Well, I think certainly, Chris, when you look at the economy, right, and you look at the MEDC, I mean, 80 or 90% of what we do is working with existing Michigan companies, helping them grow and, you know, reduce the barriers and solve some of the problems that they have in terms of growth, or working with young companies and entrepreneurs to start companies here in the state of Michigan. You know, attraction is really a small piece of what we do. It gets a lot of attention, but day in and day out, what we are focused on is helping Michigan businesses grow and be successful.
Well, you've done a great job of that. A little more to the economic gardening and a little more away from the hunting.
I think we've got to do both, right?
Well, you have to protect yourself.
Right. We've got to work with what we got and grow what we have, and then also, you know, strategically look at opportunities to make that value proposition of why Michigan's a great place to do business.
Yeah. It's interesting because a lot of people you talk to say, well, why are they out hunting? We've got, you know, companies here, you're bringing in competitors. And they don't realize that there are hunters all over your state from other states.
Well, there are. You know, we frequently hear about states that are in, you know, meeting with our Michigan businesses, talking to them about the benefits of relocating. You know, we're not about really talking about relocation. I mean, when we go out, say, to Silicon Valley and the West Coast, we're making a business case that says, you know, The cost of living is great here in Michigan. I think we rank fourth in the nation in terms of cost of living. Our quality of life is pretty amazing, right? We've got a great labor pool. You know, we're number one in the nation in terms of engineering concentration. So we're making the business case of, as you are growing, why, you know, grow in areas where it costs more, you're competing for labor, come to Michigan, open an operation, and we've been pretty successful with that.
Well, you're doing a great job, Jeff, and thanks so much for stopping by, and keep up the good work, buddy.
Thanks, Chris. Good to see you.
Good to have you here. We are here being the Grand Hotel. We're on the island for the Detroit Regional Chamber of Commerce's annual policy conference. I'm Chris Holman. You're listening and watching the Michigan Business Beat on the Michigan Business Network.